because here we have many shapes, many sizes, so colors. Yeah, any doubts? Okay, by this we are going to end our sensorial for today. Okay, still more, we have many materials okay, that we have to prepare on spot and have to do that. We'll do it in the next class. So till now, if you have any doubts in sensorial, how many are done till now sensorial? Cinder blocks? Printer, brown states, color tablets, tactile material, noise boxes, geometrical cabinet. Yeah, that comes in tactile material. Then binomial, trinomial, constructive triangles. Okay, still more we have. Okay, then we have stereognastic sense, baric sense, gustatory, olfactory. So many senses we have to do it. We will do it in the next class. Okay? No doubts till now, whatever the material. You can take out everything, three different layers you can build, okay, then you can superimpose it and then sorting, okay, you keep all the cubes together, one you isolate and show the as the child, can you find the cube which exactly fits here, or same color one or whatever you want, you can ask the child, one you can keep, okay, because 27 will be there, 3, 3, 4, 4, same thing will be there, no, same color, size, everything. One you can isolate like this and in a mixed one you can ask the child, can you find all the cubes which looks exactly like this. Okay, so now the child starts searching. Okay. Yes. Then ask the child to hold it together and see like this. Or however you want, you can give as many exercises as possible. You need to walk, then only you'll understand the material. Today, okay, so after the lunch session, before last class you had given the presentations. This class with your two partners, you start working with all these materials. Okay, whenever you are doing these activities, you have to do as you will do with the child. Okay, whatever the rhymes, whatever, you have to think others as the children and you have to do it. Then only you will get that. Okay, from the invitation in Montessori, you have to start with the invitation. Then your voice should be very clear and you should be very confident with the child. Okay, you you can start with the rolling and unrolling everything. See, until and unless, because I told you, if you go to some other schools, suddenly, because you'll be having your Montessori certificates with you, if it doesn't know anything means, what is the use? So that's my intention. You have to learn it in a perfect manner. Montessori, I'll tell you, yes. Now with this material, this is the way you have to do. But I should not talk like this. But so many, they have certificates with them, but they doesn't know what is the material. Then what is the use? No, that's why even I'm telling, if you get a chance to read Dr. Maria Montessori's books, The Secret of Childhood or The Montessori Method, so many books are there. If you go to some good stalls and all, you'll get books which are written by Dr. Maria Montessori. Maybe she has written in Italy, they are converted into English, and those books are really wonderful. Because so many mistakes we have been doing, no? With our own children itself. So many times we say negative to the child, don't do this. Okay, we think if the child takes A plus, then my child is very good. So why? See, you have to see, go according to the child's ability. Okay, why so many children, so many, maybe they'll go to engineering, medical students, why they'll suicide? No, all those things, Dr. Maria Montessori, she has written in a very good way, and this is really very interesting. How the life begins from the birth. Okay, so she used to scold our ma'am, you can even in search in the net, Meenakshi Shivaramakrishnan. Now she is very aged, now she is not taking any classes, but our time she was taking the classes, she was 80 plus that time, and she has to stand for more than 2 hours. She has to take psychology for us. So she never used to sit. And she has to carry her luggage to the first floor, even at that age. She has to carry on her own. If somebody asks, ma'am, I'll carry your things. No, I can't do it. Until I can do myself, I no need any aid. If I'm not, then I'll ask them. You go, have your coffee, tea. She has to really know. And if you see that ma'am like that, then we have to think how Maria was. See, even not even a single minute she used to waste. So maybe if you are writing some exam or test, she used to do some knitting. At that age, you think at that age, if we are doing, okay. We are still young. Yeah, we can do many things. But you just think, 80, nearly 80 she was that time. And even now, maybe after 10 years, if you go and stand in front of her, she'll recognize. See, why that is? Because they are following this method. Everything in a proper way. Okay, maybe you have brought your child here. Maybe the child starts talking something and I'm doing the class, and if she starts talking, then what the mother does? No? Then, when we are doing the course, even so many they used to bring the children, and if anyone tells shh, then she used to tell. That is not the child's problem. That is your problem. You have brought your child here. That is your mistake. Okay, don't scold the child. Children are like that. No? So she has understood the children in a better way. So if you read her life history and what she has written about the children and this Montessori method, everything, then the life will be wonderful. Even with our own family, even with our own children, we'll behave in a proper manner. Because whatever the stress, everything, we'll go to home and we'll blast our children. We'll say no to the child. See, in the school with 30 children, 40 children, we'll be very happy. As soon we go home, all those stress will come out and we blast our own children. That should not happen, okay? Whatever it is, don't say negative about the child. maybe if you're working in a traditional method, if the 30 children we have to handle, at that time it's totally different. And again, don't say, yes, you've written wrong. What you're telling is not correct. What is this? Don't say yes. Whatever you've written is correct, but write in a better way. You have to say like this. Okay? That gives positive energy to the children. And it's what we speak that gives positive energy, right? If I say, you are doing this course, you won't get more salary, then what comes to your mind? So many that think like that. If you do this course, what salary will I get? And really, I tell those who have done, so many of you are there, you have done MBA, you have done MCA, and you have done BE, and you are doing this course. Why? Because you have a passion about this. So utilize this. Okay, utilize this in a better way. No need to go home and read all these things. Okay, just come and work with the material. When you face an interview or whenever you see the material, no need to study for this. Maybe after 2 years, if you see the material, if you have understood in a proper manner, in a proper way, automatically you'll recall everything. No? So, that's what. If you are following any Montessori method, follow it in a proper manner. Then that will be utilized for the child. If something, as I told you, in a sound box, one set of box here, one set of box in the other class, then what is the use of that material? If you offer also simply the child listens and keeps, then what is the use? At least if one box the child should be able to do grading. Then okay. Okay, simply they listen and they'll keep. Then why we need all those materials and why we have to invest so much, no? So if you open your own school or wherever you work, if you know, if you have knowledge about this, then automatically you'll get name, fame, your salary, everything. And simply you are attending the class, if you have done, if you go, if you don't do anything, then, no? Please think like that. Work hard. Other 3-4 months you are going to work. That's it, right? Work hard. Okay, please work with the material. Don't think these are the small materials. What the child gets benefit, the child gets benefit with all the materials. Okay, if you want, you can see the videos in the internet, you'll get lots of information. How the other schools in other countries, how they work with the materials. Till 12th standard, they follow Montessori material. How it will be, because in the internet, we'll get all the details nowadays. If you search, if you go like that, even your knowledge improves and you'll come to know why nursery education or Montessori education or the education from 3 to 6 is important. Yeah, just tell me, A plus B whole cube, what is the... I'm very weak in maths, you just tell me. Whole cube. Yeah. Write and give. You just write and give and you just see here the material, you'll understand. Yes, any one of you come here. Come with that formula. A cube plus B cube plus 3A square take anything. Maybe one acts like 3a square b, one acts like 3ab square. Okay, if it, you have to take a as black, I think. Okay, this is a cube, b cube, 3 and 3. Yeah, a square b. Okay, you can think like this. Okay, these three are there. Okay, a square and can you see a squares are there? B. Okay. Now 3ab square. 3 are there. A black we have taken as a and b square. This is square. I'll explain once again. So a plus b all cube. Okay. So a cube plus b cube plus 3a square b plus 3ab square is the formula. Okay. Now a cube. What is the formula for a plus b whole square? 2ab. And then this is a plus b plus c all cube.
A plus b plus
c all cube. This is only a plus b. Please, trinomial cube, you have to walk out and you have to show me after the lunch session. I am showing you now a plus b whole cube. Now a plus b all cube formula is a cube plus b cube plus 3a square b. Okay, red I am taking as a here. 3 here I have 3 cubes. Okay, a square I have square here. Okay, b is my black. Okay, next 3ab square. 3 a I am taking as black. Okay, b square. Here I have a blue square. Here also I have a blue square. You just come and see the material, you'll understand with the formula. Either way you can use it. You can see, you can come and see. Just see square faces. You got it, right? Have you written the formula? What have you written? A cube, B cube, only one is there. 3 A square, I am taking this as A, here I have a square, A, I have a square and this I have B. Okay, next 3, okay, I am using this as A black, B square, B, this is B, this is in square shape. So 3ab square. So all the 3 has a, sorry, a b square. See, that's it. It indicates, ma'am, we are not applying formula here. Please don't think we are applying that formula and we can do some maths. No. Just this indicates. Okay, this material indicates this formula. This material is designed according to this formula. That's it. Okay, don't try to do algebra with this. Now the child understands that concept. Okay, somewhere it his mind, he'll utilize that, will be there in his subconsciousness. Means the child doesn't know this algebra, a square, b square, 3ab, all those things the child doesn't know. But consciousness regarding that, how it will be, square means how it will be, that consciousness will be there with the child. Actually you can use it, that's what, actually you can use these materials, actually the sensorial, see, this why she has designed to make the child more consciousness, okay. She never told you can't utilize these materials for the higher classes. Of course, yes, even while doing the mathematics, everything, you'll feel that, okay. If you show like this, really the fourth, fifth children will understand in a better way. This you can use as a teaching aids. This we are using a sensorial, but you can use in math. See, A plus B plus A cube plus B cube means A plus B plus C all cube means 2 plus 3 plus 4 all cube. 4, 3. A is 4. This is? So again here. A is 4. Got it? Then black you can take as a? So those who are very good in math, they'll understand. You're not good. You just see with the formula, you're good in math, right? Okay, then now she understood. Now the concept, this concept is based on this formula, that's it. Okay, as she told, you can utilize this material to teach for class 3, 4, 5 children. The children will understand. I didn't explain you about A plus B whole cube at that time. When people ask, so I did it. We never explain, even they didn't explain for us. Just they told this is, okay. See, you just take any one number and you can work and you can see this. A plus B, you can take 4 and 3, then measure everything and you'll get it. Okay, in the same manner, this is A plus B plus C whole cube. You write, you sit after the lunch, please work it out and show me also. We can show everyone. Okay, not now. You just write, I have to write this formula. You write down the formula, all of you sit in a circle and do it. Okay? A plus B C all A plus B plus C all cube equals A cube plus B cube plus C cube plus 3ABC plus A square BC plus 3AB square C plus 3ABC square. Once again, A cube plus B cube plus C cube plus 3ABC plus 3 square BC, 3A square BC, 3A square BC plus 3B square C, 3AB square C, sorry, plus 3ABC square. Totally, how many C? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. One more formula is there. So just work it out. back to your algebra. You and I'm very. Yes. Still doubts. They are doing algebra. Okay. So, by this we are going to end our sensorial. Okay, next we'll continue with our language. Math still have not started, no? Little bit of language will do it. Yeah, where were we? Phonetic analysis. So we'll recall those things once again. Yeah. Finished. You can work it out afternoon. I'll give you enough time. You can find, you can do any inventions. Okay. So now through the sandpaper letters, we have introduced all the sounds. Okay, so please, when you start your language in Montessori method, we start with sandpaper letters itself. Okay, so even in the other schools, at least they use sandpits. They'll give the child to trace. Okay, so you are starting with the sounds, but what happens at home? The parents, they teach them ABCD letter. Okay, so please suggest your parents that we are teaching in this manner. Please, you don't teach ABCD at home. Okay, what happens? The child will be confused. Okay, if you are in traditional method also, if you are following phonics, you have to follow only the phonics. Okay, do a variable. Please don't teach. I've seen in many schools, they'll say A, A, B, B, C, K, D, D. No, what they do, they write capital letter A, that is A for them. Small letter A they'll write, that is sound for them. This is really, see, then the child will be nowhere. Maybe he can't follow this phonics, then he can't follow that. Also, you'll be confused with. Okay, so if you are following from, if you are pre-nursery, from there you have to follow the phonics. Maybe in LKG they'll teach, UKG U doesn't teach, then God. But few schools in LKG they don't teach. As soon the child comes to UKG, they'll start teaching. Then also it's gone, because already in UKG the child knows that ABCD. Again, once again, if you start then. Okay, so if you are following, maybe Sadhav has told, I think, If you are following phonics, you have to follow everything in phonics. Okay? So you know phonics everything, but in we will see how to do that in a Montessori method. Got it? Okay? So that's what. As once if you are done with all the sandpaper letters A to Z, you are going to teach only the 26 sounds. You are not going to teach, maybe we have many phonic sounds and all those things. Okay? How to teach that in easy way and in Montessori way, we are going to learn. Okay? The first last where we have ended with group activity in oral phonetic analysis. The first activity was to last sound. Okay? The first activity is to identify or recognize the last sound. Again, the second one is for the first sound. Again, in third activity, for the same child, we are going to ask first and last sound. In the fourth activity, first and last sound for the different children and for the same children. In the fifth activity, we are going to all the sounds of the word. Any doubts? Till here, if you have any doubts, please clarify. Another child in the fourth activity for the same child. Okay, this you can do. See, maybe same group of children, 4-5 children will be there. In between, you can ask them. Because when it is a big group, then we are not able to understand who is telling, who is not telling. And even in traditional method, we don't get that much time. You just ask anyone who is working in traditional method, because them, if they give something for writing, there to be back of 30 children. Few children they'll finish first, few children they won't write at all. And once those are finished first, they'll move around, they'll start talking, and you have to control them and you have to make them to write these children. See, all these things, because of these things, if we are there for 3 hours also, at least we are wasting more than 1 hour for this. Okay, so that's why Montessori method, if you follow this method or Montessori method, each and every child will get the benefit. Okay, we'll move on to our language. Movable alphabet. Okay. I'll give you metal description, everything you just see now. Okay? This is movable alphabet. It is movable alphabet. Okay? So you're confused with that and this. That's what? Even I'm confused. What I've done there and what I'm doing in my institute, sometimes even I'll take classes there. So I am also totally confused. That's what beginning itself I asked morning. Okay. So this is called movable alphabet. Okay. Now you tell me, how do we start writing to the child or reading? Okay, we do reading, right? You just forget about this Montessori method or whatever the method. We read from letters, right? How do the child reads? What do we do beginning? How the reading happens? How do we start reading? You just think you are handling LKG children. Okay, LKG children, they now they are learning to write in traditional method, okay? They are learning to write the alphabet. But what do we do actually? We write words on the board. also the child is writing and we are going to write the words. Two letter words, three letter words, we'll write cat picture, then we'll write CAT. No? First, what we are doing in traditional method is reading and then writing comes. Okay? But here the child is writing and then reading. How does the child write? Okay? So this is the material, movable alphabet box. Okay, actually, originally if you see, whatever the script you follow, you have to use that type of letters. Okay, if you are following cursive, all the cutouts will be in cursive print. If you are following printed, all the letters should be in a printed form. Okay, usually in Montessori method or some other, this is actually not a movable alphabet box. If you see movable alphabet box, all the vowels will be in blue color. All the consonants will be in pink color. Okay. So whatever the script you follow or whatever the script you are teaching, sandpaper and all, you have to keep that type of movable alphabet box. Okay. Now, along with this box, there will be a mat. Okay, one mat will come. That mat will be in four line book will be there, no? That concept they have used and they have made a mat. We'll get that mat also. Okay. Now what happens? Now the child knows all the sounds. You have done oral phonetic analysis, the fifth activity, correct? You are telling cat, which is the first sound of cat. What comes after k? After a? Ch. Now the child knows the sounds, all the sounds. Okay, now we are giving writing to the child. Okay, now please listen, look carefully. Okay, maybe one child is here. I'll ask the child, when you listen cat, which is the first letter, okay, which is the first sound in cat, okay, k. Where is k here? Directly, I'm not giving any writing, I'm not giving writing instruments, I'm not giving paper, pencil or something, okay, through the material, is writing through the material. Got it? Okay? So this is before the child writes. This activity is before the child writes. Okay? Now the first sound is k. Where is k here? When I say where is k here, the child takes out this. But the child is not saying this as C. It is saying this as k. Okay? Just arrange it. Okay. What comes after k in cat?